Hello, everybody, to the next DSpace Coffee Break session. Today, about a very exciting and brand new product, the MicroOrderBox 3. But before we dive into the product topic, I want to start with a very short explanation. What is the main challenge in regards to rapid control prototyping? Why do you need rapid control prototyping systems like the MicroOrderBox? And I try to summarize this to just one sentence. And for me, this one sentence is, how do you bring ideas to life? How do you do that in the real world with real sensors and actuators, in a real car, in the real vehicle? And this is exactly where the DSpace rapid control prototyping systems like the MicroOrderBox come into play. We offer you a broad portfolio of highly flexible, high-performance systems to bring your ideas into life. And for you as a function developer, this means that you can prove that it really works out in the end, on real streets, in the real vehicle. And for those who said a little bit too abstract, I brought a few examples with me. And the first one I want to talk about is from Audi, who developed an autonomous car which drives autonomously around a racetrack, the Hockenheimring in Germany. This was the RS7 concept car, maybe some of you know that. And there, a MicroOrderBox 3 was used in the trunk to execute some of the control strategies and to perform the signal processing for several sensors and actuators. So pretty exciting one. The next example is from General Motors and the University of Michigan, which worked on a topic of fuel reduction, energy reduction of their fleets. And what they have done is they proved that their platooning algorithms really worked efficiently on the real streets. So they equip the fleet of cars with MicroOrderBoxes and execute their platooning algorithms on the MicroOrderBox. Next topic is from Rimac, and that's very exciting. So how do you control an electric supercar with more than 1,000 HP? And also this was done with the MicroOrderBox, which was used as an overlaying controller to communicate with different ECUs during the development of the concept car, concept one car. And the last thing I want to mention here is from Mitsubishi Motors. They also used MicroOrderBoxes in an electric race car which participated in the Pikes Peak race in the US. And there the MicroOrderBox was also used as an overlaying controller. And I think Mitsubishi finished as the second place for an electric car, so very successful. Here, also a very nice example where MicroOrderBoxes are used. And these are just a few examples, because we as DSpace, we want to be a partner for you. We want to help you in the function development phase with our systems, so we have a complete tool chain from A, autonomous driving, to Z, like zero emissions. And this in the classic mechatronic application, so executing controller strategies, but now also in the data-driven development domain, which comes up in advanced driver assistance systems and autonomous driving. And now I want to come to the product-related topics, to the MicroOrderBox 3. So in general, what makes the MicroOrderBox so successful? And for me, these are some dedicated reasons. So at first, it's a pretty compact system, which is robust. It is passive cooled, so no rotating elements inside of it. You can directly plug it into the vehicle, connect it with the onboard power supplies, and start working with it. So very easy to handle. Don't worry about any robust or in-vehicle use specific requirements. Next thing is, we have a broad portfolio of automotive IOs and buses and network interfaces with high functionality. So you as a customer or as a function developer can really focus on your main task, which is developing the control strategy. You do not need to develop IO functionalities like PWM generation or something else. We already have done this for you. You can just use it with the MicroOrderBox 3. And the last thing is, we have some dedicated extensions for different use cases. Like in this MicroOrderBox here, we have a second slice of the MicroOrderBox with a free programmable FPGA for executing very fast control loops or to be used for eDrive applications, engine applications, or something else. And of course, we also have adaptations for advanced driver assistance systems and autonomous driving. So this is why the Micro Autobox 3 is and was a very successful product in the past. And we now thought about, when starting with the next generation, with the Micro Autobox 3, what should we improve? And this is where I want to talk about today, about three major benefits of the next generation of the Micro Autobox, which is, at first, we saw that you need more computation power, especially in ADAS and autonomous driving applications. So if you want to execute a trajectory controller, you need a lot of computational performance, and we want to achieve that with the next generation of the Micro Autobox. Second thing is, we see a trend towards centralization. So the EE architecture of the vehicles are changing. They're coming up new ECUs like domain controllers. You need more gateways, etc. So buses and networks really have an increasingly importance in the vehicle, and we want to support this also with the Micro Autobox system. I show you how we do this in the next in this session. And the last thing is, we see that you doing test drives now also on wheel streets, driven through ADAS and AD algorithms, which need to be proved on wheel streets, there is also an increasing demand in regards to functional safety. And we want to support you in this regards and hire the functional safety coverage, even though it's a prototyping system, with the Micro Autobox. So let's talk about what we have done. First thing is higher computation power. And if we compare this to the Micro Autobox 2, we have up to 16 times more computational performance than the predecessor system, which is really a boost. But the best thing is that's per core. And we now have 4 cores for model computation. So theoretically, you have 4 times, 16 times more computational performance, where you especially benefit in applications which needs bigger models, which needs a lot of computational performance. That's exactly where the Micro Autobox has a big benefit compared to the predecessor. Next thing was buses and networks. So what have we done in regards to that? And for that, every Micro Autobox comes with automotive Ethernet interfaces directly on the system, independently of the variant. So every Micro Autobox has 2 automotive Ethernets, and in addition, 3 standard Ethernet interfaces, which can be used for different use cases. But that's not all. We will come up with a new dedicated variant for bus and network support of the Micro Autobox, which will be called DS1521. And this really offers a lot of new functionality. And before we talk about that, I want to compare it also to the Micro Autobox 2. So imagine you have an application where you need CAN-FD interfaces, you need FlexWay interfaces, and you maybe also need automotive Ethernet. So how did the Micro Autobox 2 look like? In this case, you needed a 3-slice Micro Autobox. So a pretty big system. Compared that to the Micro Autobox 3, you just need 1 slice. So everything into 1 slice, which is half the price and a third of the size than the predecessor system. So a real customer benefit. And it will look like that. So there are a lot of interfaces available on the system. So we have 8 CAN-FD channels. We have FlexWay interfaces on the system. We have additional automotive Ethernet interfaces on the system, and also a bunch of standard IOs. So this is really a big benefit compared to the predecessor. And the best thing is, it's also scalable. So if you need more interfaces than that, which are equipped on just 1 slice, you can just add another one and double the size and double the amount of interfaces which are equipped on the Micro Autobox. So a pretty cool new improvement in regards to buses and networks. And now I come to the last topic, which I want to show here in regards to the main benefits of the system, which is functional safety. So in regards to functional safety, we have done a lot of hardware adaptations of the system, and we oriented us on commonly used standards in the industry, like the EGAS concept, a three-level safety concept, basically. And we also had a look at the ISO 26262. And with this, we come up with a three-level safety system on the micro order box with dedicated hardware adaptations, and we are also offering you the needed software algorithms like a challenge response monitor or memory monitors, etc. So the first step is we have the functionality and we have the three-level safety system here. What we do in addition to that, we're working together with the German TÜV on a dedicated safety manual, which comes up and which shows you as our customers the best practices how to use a micro order box in a prototyping setup. We're currently working on that and we plan to come up with this in this year. So if you have any questions to that, please directly contact us. Before I come to the end, I also want to mention a few minor benefits of the system, which are compared to the ones I showed you before, not that big, but they help you in your everyday work. So I called it benefits in everyday work. And the first thing is, what we now have is we have four status LEDs on the system, which can be directly used from the model. You can use it in subsystems, etc., to directly show the status of your controller, which is running on the micro order box on side of the system. So small adaption with a big benefit from my perspective. Next thing is we have a USB interface available, which can be used to lock data during your test drives. So all data which is available inside of your model, inside of your controller you're executing, can be locked on a USB drive for further use in the laboratory after the test drive. And we also improved that mechanism. So you can do that without a rebuild directly from control desk. And we are also now using the MDA4 format, which is a commonly used standard in regards to data logging. Last thing I want to talk about here is we now also have the possibility to equip a micro order box with a Wi-Fi interface, which means you do not need to connect a cable to the trunk to connect to the micro order box. So wireless use of the micro order box from controllers, for example, for measurement of the current application, reduces the cabling effort. So, and with this, I come to the end of my presentation today. And I think the micro order box is really a future-proof system which addressing the main market trends like computational performance, bus and network support, and also new requirements in regards to functional safety. So this really is a main benefit, or a lot of benefits for customers, but it maintains the idea of the micro order box because it's still compact, it's still passive cooled, and it's still robust to be used in the car. So it is still a real micro order box. And with this, I want to close my session today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any further questions in regards to our RCP systems, please feel free to contact us and come back to us. Thank you very much.
DSpace, your partner in simulation and validation.